Thanks, Kim Cole. I just had to check my calendar there today to see where we, in fact, on April 1st, I was wondering, were we listening to some April Fool's joke to be subjected to the previous contribution from Labour deputies who seem to be inhabiting some planet very, very different to the rest of us, and the insult that people would put up the model of the National Health Service in Britain, which is indeed the best model of public health care, where it's based on a taxation system where those who have the ability to pay pay through their taxation, and those who need the service get it free at the point of access. And the idea that the government's proposal on universal health insurance has any relationship to that is quite simply farcical. And either the two deputies who spoke before us have no comprehension of that, that they clearly don't understand what's been in front of us, or else they're engaged in a deliberate deceit. Either way, thankfully, the population at large are on to them and their ilk. The reality here is that what this proposal is a substantial elimination of any notion of a public health service, and it comes on top of the systematic undermining of that system which has taken place already. And I don't blame Fine Gael deputies for that. We know Fine Gael stands for privatisation and so on, and more parity, but the other clowns going along with it is an entirely different matter, I have to say. There is no secret
about... Don't refer to members as clowns, please.
Okay, I'm not, yeah, okay, I could think of something I won't.
Unparliamentary, as they say.
Okay.
Sorry, Deputy, you do, you know, you're in the House of Parliament.
I am.
And you do have to adhere to rules like everybody else.
I do, Kim Corley, right? And I didn't mean any disrespect to any circus performers or others by the remark. The Dutch model, which is being promoted by the government in this system, has already been found wanting. It's one which has actually resulted not in a single-tier system, but a three-tier system, with welfare recipients and those who can't afford to pay becoming defaulters. And in essence, what's being proposed here is people being frog-marched into a system of private health insurance. And the whole ethos is wrong. Only this morning, the Health Committee was discussing the top-up payments, being, which are thankfully ceasing now, to a number of medical staff in our hospitals. And if you look at when we put down questions on that, the answers that we got were that the hospitals put forward a business plan to justify those excess payments. Now, why would a hospital even have a business plan? Clearly, the whole ethos is about commodifying health rather than dealing with it in an appropriate manner, and I don't think that that is acceptable. In Ireland, families, at great pain to themselves, already pay thousands of euros in private health insurance. We know that. But why do they do it? It's not that they're some sort of snobs who don't want to share a room with somebody if they get sick. It's because they don't have confidence in the public health system. And they're paying as a way, if you like, of trying to get their foot in the door. That simply isn't acceptable. But what it shows is that people would support a system whereby maybe, for example, higher PRSI contributions or whatever were being paid in return for a properly funded public health service. That isn't what the government has on the cards with this proposal. What's at play here is, in essence, making people pay at every level. And I think we do need to go back to the British model and look at that, because it hasn't been matched anywhere else in the world since then, where people's access, as I said, is free at the point of care. About 60% of all institutional long-term care, pharmaceuticals, vision care and so on, are all dealt with by the NHS. We need investment more in the precautionary levels, in the initial levels of GP services, rather than just throwing people into the hospital system later on. But a Dutch model and a compulsory assurance model on a population that is already failing to make ends meet because of years of austerity is not the way forward. In actual fact, it's been demonstrably shown that once you implement and give over your service to the private sector, then inevitably charges will rise. And that's where Dutch families have found themselves outdone, out of the market, and in a much worse place, and a million years from the NHS or any idea of a proper publicly funded health system.
Thank you, Deputy Collins.